combustion train analysis was done, and the elemental composition of glucose was determined. And from that, the mass percent of the elements carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen in glucose was determined previously to be 39.99% carbon, 6.72% hydrogen, and 53.2% oxygen. From this mass percent data, determine the empirical formula for glucose. So in order to determine the empirical formula for glucose, let's just assume that we have a 100 gram sample of glucose. With these given percent mass percentages, then I can say that I must have 39.99 grams of carbon in my 100 gram sample, 6.72 grams of hydrogen in my 100 gram sample, and 53.2 grams of oxygen in my 100 gram sample. To determine the empirical formula, I simply need to figure out the number of moles of each of these elements in that 100 gram sample. I do this by multiplying by the inverse of the molar mass for each of these elements. So for carbon, it's 12 grams carbon for every 1 mole of carbon. For hydrogen, it's 1 gram hydrogen for every 1 mole of hydrogen. And for oxygen, it's 16 grams oxygen for every 1 mole of oxygen from the periodic table. From this math, I can determine the number of moles. And for carbon, it is, in that sample, 3.32 moles of carbon. And for the hydrogen, it's just 6.72 moles of hydrogen. And for the oxygen, it's 3.33 moles of oxygen. Within air, I can say I need to divide all of these number of moles by the smallest number of moles, which is 3.32, or 3.3 if I rounded it off. And then I'll divide this by 3.32. And I end up with a whole number ratio of 1 mole of carbon to 2 moles of hydrogen to 1 mole of oxygen. This gives me my empirical formula for glucose, which is C H2O. Now the next question is, from the empirical formula and knowing that the molar mass of glucose is 180, determine the molecular formula for glucose. So we know the relationship between the molecular formula for any molecule and its empirical formula is some whole number integer value, 1 and up. And the way we determine what the value of n is we take the molar mass of the molecular formula and we divide by the molar mass of the empirical formula to determine the value of n. This case, we're told that the molar mass is 180. Looking at this empirical formula, I calculate 12 plus 2 plus 16 is 30. So the molar mass is 30, so 180 divided by 30 equals 6. So the molecular formula then equals 6 times the empirical formula. The molecular formula is equal to 6 times the empirical formula, which was CH2O. So I multiply distributively 6 by each of those elements. And so the molecular formula is C6H12O6. And that indeed is the molecular formula of glucose.